It's a university that makes many Kentuckian students attend, and one that can make many houses divided. University of Kentucky President Eli Capilouto is here with us today, and thank you for joining us today.
It's a delight to be here.
Well, glad to have you here, and tell us too. Okay, so the legislative session, it just ended, and there were some cuts that affected the university. Tell us about those, and how are they going to be impacting students?
Sure. Let me say, I'm always appreciative of our elected officials. I have the opportunity to represent my university. I'm honored to do so, but I see the hard choices they face, and I'm appreciative of what they did. At the end of the day, we have a 3% cut in our base budget, recognizing that since 2008, we've had a $70 million decrease, so this is an additional decrease. I'm glad that it's less than was anticipated before the session started.
But we also do, you were mentioning that there's some good news out of the session as well. Talk about that.
Yes, we have as a focus at the University of Kentucky to tackle the gaps in health care. We call these health disparities. Unfortunately, in Kentucky, when it comes to opioids, cancer, obesity, high blood pressure, those things, we do much worse than other states. It is a priority for the University of Kentucky to advance research on those fronts, in our laboratories, and in and with community. We know we can make a difference. We're doing so in cancer, for instance. We have a comprehensive cancer center designation by the National Cancer Institute. So we have been awarded $40 million to heighten our activities in this area. We take this most seriously. We say we are the university for Kentucky. These are Kentucky's most serious health problems, and we want to make a difference when it comes to those.
So $40 million, and so when will that money take effect? So you'll have it this fall so they can start working?
Well, that's our plan. We're getting our, finalizing our plans. We have a building coming out of the ground now. It'll open in the fall. We'll be able to finish more space there, put together some infrastructure and talent. That's what it takes to tackle something as big as this. We also, through this funding, are positioned for these significant increases in the funding by the National Institutes of Health. And I have to applaud Leader McConnell for his efforts in that regard. In opioid abuse alone, $500 million new dollars. We think in Kentucky, unfortunately, we were the epicenter of this. We have a lot we can teach the nation about what we're doing. There's more that we can explore to see what works to turn these horrible numbers around. You have 300 people died last year in Louisville alone, 42,000 people across the United States, and the numbers are unabated.
So a lot of work happening at UK. And before you go, really quick, let me know. So you're here in Louisville today, and it's because you're trying to meet with new students who are coming to UK.
Yeah, nearly 20% of our entering class comes from Jefferson County. So we have a lot of them here. These are the ones that have been admitted. We have a reception for them. I get to spend time with them and their families.
All right, well, good to have you here, President. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for the time.